We talk a lot on our channel about how great it is to be debt-free.
But we've never really talked about how to get debt-free. So we're going to do that right now.
Here we go. Yeah.
Wow.
Well, hey everybody, I'm Bill.
And I'm Elizabeth. Live simple.
Live free. And our channel name, Live Simple, Live Free.
Yeah.
That's our financial strategy.
Yeah.
That's our goal. To live simple, what does that mean, to live simple?
Well, one of the things I think we've learned with everything that's happened in our life is that life really doesn't consist of possessions. I've said this before, it consists of relationships, experiences, and we can enjoy having things in our life, but we can't let them be the focus, and we can't put ourselves into debt for the sake of buying more than we need. And, when we live our life more simply, financially, it makes all the difference in the world.
Yep. living simple means not going into debt specifically to buy stuff that you're craving. Just to live a more simple and content life.
Yeah, yeah.
The live free part is, occasionally I've had someone say, what are you talking about? Nobody can live for free.
Yeah, that's
I'm not talking about living for free.
Yeah, without paying for anything.
I'm talking about living free from the bondage and stress of debt.
Yeah, and of being under the water financially all right. The time. That is stressful.
So that's our basic philosophy. And, we were debt-free for years and really, truly love it.
Yes.
And then when we moved to Virginia and we bought this house that we love
so much. Which is 900 square feet, so we can share it with Pop.
It's a small house, but big enough for my dad, yeah. We ended up with a small mortgage when we moved in here, and we've been concentrating on getting it paid off. It looks like, praise God, we're going to be out of debt with the house and debt-free in another couple of months again.
Yeah.
So right back into, this whole thing of paying this off is into the debt-free lifestyle that we are living.
Yeah.
Because any debt that comes along, which we very rarely ever do use, but as soon as we do, we pay it off as fast as we can.
It's only been things like really unexpected big medical bills. Then we pay off as quick as we can. Or something like the only way we could get into this house. But we got into it as inexpensively as we could. And it's just right big enough. It doesn't have to be bigger.
So we talk a lot on our channel about the debt-free lifestyle, but we've never really talked about how to get debt-free. And I know for many people, you look at us and other people talking about debt freedom, it's like, that's great, but how do you possibly do that?
I can remember a time in our life when it would have seemed impossible to us. Yes.
Well, it is possible.
Yeah.
I actually have a seminar. It's a debt elimination wealth building seminar that I have been teaching at churches all around for years now. And it teaches you how to get out of debt, the average American with the average amount of income and average amount of debt, to get out of debt, including your mortgage, in about 7 years. And then once you're debt free, then you can take the money that's freed up because you're no longer wasting it on interest, and you can begin to invest it for a much better future.
Yeah, just begin to make decisions about how you want to build for your future.
So I recently taught this seminar at our church, and it was a 3.5-hour seminar that I did on a Saturday morning, and I recorded it for you guys.
Yeah.
So I have broken it up now into four parts, and we will be presenting my debt elimination wealth building seminar for the next 4 days.
Yeah.
Now, the first three parts are basically the debt elimination and wealth building part. It's a secular financial course about how to get out of debt, how to use your current income to get out of debt, and why you should do that. And we talk a lot about the damage that paying interest can do to your long-term financial goal. And then the fourth part is what I call the biblical perspective on debt freedom. And, we look and see, what does God think about debt?
Yeah, what does the Bible say about it?
Right.
Right.
So, starting tomorrow, it will be the next 4 days. Every day there will be a new, because we have four parts. And I really hope you will dig in and listen to this and apply what you're going to learn. You will be able to take your debts. So start with a list of all of your debts and just put the name, the monthly payment, and the total amount that you owe. You'll be able to take those numbers and plug it into the system, and you will know exactly to the month when you'll be debt free.
Yeah.
And I love teaching this course. I love when people have their eyes open and this light goes on. It's, wow, this really is possible. And there's always so much excitement in the room when people who are drowning in debt realize that if they just manage their money a little bit differently, the same money they're earning anyway, they can get out of debt in just a few years.
You know, there's something that is called a paradigm shift. Spelled like paradigm. But anyway, paradigm shift. And when we finally went through that shift, and we did it the hard way.
It was really tough, yes.
And made the decision forever to not rely on debt. That has been a life-changing experience. And even with having to get a house so we could share with Pop and all this, everything that we've learned has gone into making this also a workable, smooth transition. And goodness, I'm coming up on 65. You know, if I'd ended up with a major mortgage at this age, it would have been impossible to ever think about being free again.
Right.
So I'm just saying that what we've been able to learn with all this has transformed our life, in this last decade plus. And so we've seen it make a difference in other people's lives too.
Right. Yeah. So she just mentioned a paradigm shift. What is a paradigm?
Right. Well, that's good to explain it, actually.
It's your underlying base or understanding of truth upon which you build all of your life decisions.
Right. It's your view of things.
Your worldview. For instance, the world is flat. Obviously, the world is flat. Everybody can see that. It's flat. The entire world, trade routes, wars, everything was built on the paradigm that the world was flat. Then somebody came along and said, no, it's a globe. Once that paradigm shift happened, everything changed with trade routes and everything like that.
Yeah.
Totally changed.
Yeah. Once they realized it was a big ball.
Yeah.
Yep.
Once you have a different paradigm, a different understanding of truth, you base different decisions on that. So the financial paradigm is that you can live better if you use credit. You can live a better lifestyle when you use credit. You need to change your paradigm to you can live a better lifestyle without using credit. And that's a very difficult thing to do because most of us have been taught that credit is normal, it's expected, and that's the way to live the good life.
Even necessary.
Yeah.
Right. And we can tell you, and we're going to be getting into a lot of this, Bill will be in these next few days, but I can tell you hands down, you can live life well. Even if your income's not all that great, whatever's happening, you can live life well without having to rely on using your future earnings to pay for something you're getting now.
Right.
You can live your life well based on just paying for getting what you can pay for. It's
right.
It works.
You can live your life better.
You can live your life much less stress-free, much better. One thing I can say for sure is that back when we owned a pretty good-sized business, we owned 4 homes, we had, what could be considered a pretty successful life. We were both working, it was harder for me to go out and just buy something that I needed because I never was completely sure if we were going to have enough money if I did that. Nowadays, because I know where the money's going, I know we can pay for bills ahead of time, and I know that if I need to go get something, I feel free to go and get what I need or to give something to someone with great joy because I don't have to worry about it. That has been pretty cool for I'm a real tightwad personality anyway, but it's been wonderful for me to take somebody out to lunch and know I'm going to pay for it and it's fine.
Yeah.
Without a credit card. That's right.
So I hope you'll join us for the next 4 days starting tomorrow morning as you can learn how to live a better life without credit, how to get out of debt. with just your current paycheck.
Yeah. Pretty exciting, actually. Yeah. I just pray this becomes a great blessing in anybody's life that needs it. Yeah.
All right, thanks. Join us tomorrow. Live simple.
Live free.
You'll be blessed.
Okay. Bye, guys. We love you.
All right.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.